Hi guys, Chuff here again, and this is Vulkan. I'm just going to go through a quick unboxing. I picked him up today from the Warhammer 40k open day at Warhammer World. Have to say, probably one of the best organised I've seen there. The queue was not horrendous once you got in. Fortunately, I got to the front anyway, because I got early enough. I got there at 9 o'clock, so it was quite good. So this is Vulkan. I have waited a long time for my Primarch model. I'm so happy he's here now. I've actually taken the liberty of taking the bits out of the black box, which can get a bit stiff and difficult to get it out. So, as always, you get a nice little picture of him built, and then they show you a picture at the back, which obviously there must be something there to look at once he's done. You never know, so keep hold of it. You never know what you need it for. So, two boxes. Put that one to one side. He says if you've got space, there we go. So this, I have already been through, to be honest. Just checking it all out. Hold that down. In actual fact, no, let's not do that. Let's just get this stuff out. We'll put it back in afterwards. Well, it's going to go in the cleaner in a minute anyway. So we'll start with all these bits. So first things first, let me zoom in a bit, change the focus point. There we go. Right, so this is actually the piece that Vulkan himself will stand over, because he's stepping over this. And I do like the rebar, the way that this has been broken up. So that's just a nice piece of diorama. Where else? We've got more bits of diorama that have been broken off, and I've got this peg system, which you'll see how it fits. Peg at the bottom there and peg in there. And we'll start off with this, which has, let's see if I can bring it into focus up here a bit more as well. There we go. Right. So we've got this, which goes over one of his shoulders, containing the shoulder pad of the armour. That looks beautiful. We've got a backpack with some canisters of promethium that feed his heavy flamer thing. And then this piece, I think, also gets fed by it. The back of this goes into this area here. And this piece actually fits to the back of his armour, and that's where his head is. So you've got all these flames, as it were, that come out. So that looks really nice. I do like the detail on this. So there's that. Then we've got the actual heavy flamer itself. So if you look, the hand is missing, it's cast elsewhere. And you've got the heavy flamer, the pipe work for it going up. You've got the symbolism of the salamanders and flame works and stuff in there, which will probably do gold out of that. And then you've got the other arm. This is the one that goes under that big giant drake skull. So that's pretty cool. And this is awesome. Just the amount of detail on this cloak is phenomenal. The way it kind of tethers off at the end. On the other side of said cloak, you've got, I don't know if you can pick them out very well, there you go, nice bit of logoing, which is a kind of writing from Nocturne. So you've got that. Then we've got this is the weapon that was made by Ferris Manus and given to Vulkan. Which he didn't use much, but he took it to Istvan because his brother was there to show his camaraderie with him. Some tassels, everyone loves tassels. And then you've got his face himself. I have to say, the detail on this face is gorgeous. And the ears. So I really like that. Obviously. And then you've got kind of like a drake tassely bit, a bit more of a logo. The hand for that missing arm, new with the heavy flamer. And then you've got Dawnbringer. Really nice. Love all the detail on this. All the way down. And you got it on the top as well, some detail. Really nice. Have to say, I think Forge World are getting better all the time. So, that's in the first packet. In the second, two black bases. Yeah. More dioramic scene. Now this, I love. Really love this. Just the way it's been layered up from there to there. You've got this dying marine, you've got these peg holes for all the bits to go in. A little bit of tubing and pipe work coming out, diamond kind of plating, and the natural bits. Really nice. And I think they've given space for magnets as well, so maybe they're listening, maybe they're watching. If you're watching, say hello. Please comment, rate and subscribe as well, Forge World. Some more rocks and earth, and then this kind of pillory bit which is at his back, and you can see two corresponding holes now, so maybe they are allowing for magnetization. You never know. This dude is awesome. I expect a lot of these to be bought and sold on eBay, because dead marine or what? Really nice, well put together, smashed into the ground. Really cool. Really, really cool. I do like that guy. He'd make a great object to market. Now, this is the main body itself. So, just look, he says, at all that fine work there. All that fine work there. All the way up. And his chest. That's obviously where his head goes, and the arms. And you got that back piece, and then the backpack on. And then the cloak in as well, so I'll have to have a look how it all goes. I like the. Let me see if I can zoom in a bit. No, that's as much as I can get. Well, focus. What's the best focal point? There we go. So you got the 18th Legion stamped there. So yeah, hopefully I'll get him painted quite soon. There's a fair bit to clean up. So hopefully we'll see this guy soon. So please comment, rate and subscribe.